Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 2 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here at Vault 13. Stupid mistakes. Why do I keep mining around anyway? Whatever will we find? We're searching, of course, as always, for the Garden of Eden creation kit. Rats. So remember the beginning of the first Fallout game. Encountering rats. This is the poor man's motion sensor. Now I have the motion sensor. Just... I don't use it. Hold on a second. I need to clear my playing space here. Alright. We'll just charge right in. It does look sealed up tight, which of course our characters cannot tell at the moment from over here. And nothing unexpected so far. I guess all the rats that we killed, well, our descendant killed in the beginning of the first installment, are still dead. This large door is the link between the vault and the outside world. This looks to be the computer that controls a door nearby. Yes, we're gonna do something sometime soon. Is the, no. Looking for the body of the overseer. Hold on. I'm trying to look at... Oh, that's part of this crack or whatever. Well, look at that. Can I science this while I'm here? For science. I guess nothing happens there. Okay. In a new zone. There's someone here. A short man carrying a book in his hands. Locker. I remember this is here. Empty. Oh my. You see a large death claw. The creature is composed of rippling muscles, sharp teeth, and claws. This one watches you with strangely intelligent eyes. Myron, what would you like to do? Do you want to charge the death claw? Go right ahead. I'm not attacking yet. We come in peace?
It talks.
Yeah, I was tempted to just open fire on it, but something told me that we'd see something unexpected here at Vault 13.
Do not fear me, human. I do not intend to harm you. I am Gruthar, leader of this Deathclaw pack. Why have you come here?
To kick your ass, no. How is it possible a Deathclaw could talk? And talk so well?
Forgive me. I do not mean to be rude, but I do not see that this is relevant to our conversation. I can speak your tongue. I can read your written word. What more needs be said?
I don't mean to pry, but surely you can understand my interest in this matter.
Yes, I certainly can. Very well. If we part as friends, human, you should speak with Goris. He has more understanding in this matter than I. He can usually be found in the vault library.
You want to add him to friend list? Thank you. I look forward to meeting Goris.
Why have you come here?
I'm looking for something called a geck. I was told I could find one here.
A geck? Is that not a small lizard? No, wait. That is a gecko. I am sorry, but I do not know what a geck is, nor where it can be found.
You'll like this answer. A relative of yours. To be honest with you, I'm not exactly sure what it is myself. Would it be all right with you if I looked for it?
I am sorry, but I do not allow just anyone to wander these halls. I am responsible for the safety of all who live here, and I must exercise caution. However, I will look for this geck, and if I find it, I will let you know.
I can understand your concern. You don't know me well enough to trust me. What if I help you out somehow, and in return you allow me to look around? Gruthas stares at you intently for a moment.
You would be interested in helping us? Yes. I sense little evil in you. Very well. I shall place my trust in you.
Thank you. Gruthar can sense evil.
There are many machines here, machines built by humans. Deathclaw hands cannot use these machines. However, there is one machine that understands questions. I ask it to run the other machines, and it obeys.
Well, like the main server, something like that.
This machine no longer listens. It will no longer run the other machines. We are running out of food and water. I have ordered raids on the human lands so that we may survive. I am not proud of this, and I would put an end to it. If you repair this machine, I will be able to feed my people once again. I will gladly stop the raids. Will you agree to this?
Voice recognition module. Sounds like the voice recognition module has gone bad on you. Let's go take a look.
Thank you. The machine is in the vault control center on the third level. If you can repair it, please do so. I am placing my trust in you. Please do not betray it. You are welcome here.
Oh, jeez. I won't let you down, Gruthar. You have my word on that. Vault control center, third level. Gruthar, leader of the Deathclaws. Oh, he's the leader.
Greetings, friend. Have you examined the machine yet?
No, actually, I have not moved, but I'll get on it. Oh, my. You see the most impressive Deathclaw you could imagine. The creature must be unique among its kind. 250 hit points and is wielding a claw. Can I go in here, Gruthar? Can I science this? You know what, before I science this... just in case I'll be sciencing this in an alternate reality, because then we'll die. Computer. Well, they just ran in, okay. Failing to learn anything. Okay, if you're gonna help, then actually help. Failing? Scatter, people. You heard the man. Nothing. bed. It looks pretty comfortable after what you've been sleeping on. Sulik, because I try to ask him stuff about... Can you make the text go away? Here, Sulik.
What you be?
Can you consult the spirits for me?
Spirits be willing to talk. What you want?
What do they tell you about this place?
Look for the vision that does not belong.
Just as always, it makes absolutely nothing to me. But okay, thanks. Okay. Man with a book. Short man with a book in his hands. Hello, I'm Joseph the Herbalist. What can I help you with? I wanted to ask you some questions. What would you like to know? Are you a prisoner here? No, I'm not a prisoner. I stay because I'm needed here. I've learned to accept the fact that some of my patients are Deathclaws. That's very commendable of you. Can you leave here if you want? Yes, I can, and often do. I have to collect my herbs from time to time, and I've never been stopped. I used to wonder if the Deathclaws were secretly following me and whether or not they would stop me if I tried to leave. So one day I put the theory to test. I traveled to another town and stayed there for a week or so before returning. When I got back, I was warmly welcomed. Guthar, the pack leader, came to me privately and personally thanked me for coming back. No, I am definitely here because I want to be. Good idea. I'm glad to see it worked. What can you tell me about the Deathclaws? Well, let's see. Deathclaws appear to be mutated Jackson's chameleons, the horned variety. There are a lot of similarities still present, but an even greater number of differences. The mutation factor is quite high. This species is highly intelligent, about the equivalent of an 8-year-old, with some individuals reaching human normal level. Their learning capacity is very high, and they are capable of abstract thought and reasoning. Although they do not have vocal cords, the Deathclaws seem to mimic human speech much the same as a parrot does. I have yet to discover the exact mechanism behind this, so I'm unable to say more at this time. Socially, they are pack animals with a very rigid code of ethics. They are led by an alpha male who rules with the mutual consent of the pack. They appear to be extremely loyal to the pack as a whole, treating it as a family unit, rather than having individual families as humans do. Their sense of right and wrong is very well defined. They do follow a code of ethics that is enforced by the pack as a whole. Violence is never used as a solution to a problem among the pack, as far as I can see. There have been no capital crimes committed here, so I can't say how these are handled. That's about all I can think of for now. I hope this helps you. Wow. I'm impressed with your knowledge. How did you come to be here in the first place? I was gathering some herbs one night when a voice called to put me out of the darkness.
I have been watching you, it said, and I know that you are a healer.
Are you dedicated to your art enough to heal someone foreign to you, someone whom many would consider an enemy? I answered that I respected all life and do my best to heal the injured, regardless of who or what they were. I thought it was some thief or raider who had gotten himself hurt and needed a doctor. You can't begin to imagine my surprise when a couple of Deathclaws stepped out of the night with an injured companion. Somebody had shot him up real good. I told them I couldn't work on him where he were, so they blindfolded me and brought me here. I've been here from that day forward. You are a truly dedicated man who deserves recognition. Thanks for the information. I'll be headed out here. All right. Am I injured? Wait. Not really. Oh, I'm radiated. I wonder if you unradiate me. Why, certainly. This will take a while, so you'll have to stay here overnight. You'll need to take this, drink this, all of it. I know it tastes foul. Now, just lie back and I'll wake you in the morning. Saying hello. And he says nothing back. How rude. Okay, so he's... Okay, I'm no longer radiated. It's probably only like 4 points or something like that. Alright, let's talk to this other Deathclaw then. This is the ones with strangely intelligent eyes.
Forgive. I no speak well. I try talk you.
Is this the one, like, with an 8-year-old intelligent? Who are you?
I Thern. Who you?
Well, these rad rats. I've yet to run into one. I keep hearing about rad rats lately. It's a pleasure to meet you, Thern. I'm Andrea King.
You want what?
What are you doing here?
I guard hall. Safety of pack goal.
You're doing a great job. No offense, but just how smart are you?
How I judge? Not know. Some things understand much. Some things understand little. Lot things understand not.
Yeah, well, that describes me as well. Well, just passing the time. Typical Deathclaw. Going down. This makes me nervous when I hear that growl. Second floor. Deathclaws. And, Deathclaws.
Hello, human.
Sorry to bother you, but who are you?
I, Dar, warrior.
I'm Andrea King, Dar.
What you want?
What is your job at the vault?
Dar, guard hall and keep peace. Nothing more.
Well, you're doing fine, Dar. Just keep it up. Please don't take offense, but how educated are you?
Not much, but I learn. Guthar, he leader. Tell us all learn.
Some of these answers. Tempting, but I don't want to bring these death claws down on my head. No way. Guthar is right. You should all try to educate yourselves. I mean, those would be really, like, a problem if we had to fight our way out of here. Did I read this already? Guthar is right. You should try to educate yourselves. Passing time. Alright, we will look around and stuff. I'm guessing we can just go in anywhere, I'm hoping. We won't be brutally attacked. You're not moving. It's because he's in the mine. Failing. You even see a Garden of Eden creation kit? You might have women here that just of the Deathclaw variety, Myron. Don't tell me that's a problem for you. I'm sure you're diversified in your lovemaking duties. Also looking for some small energy cell. Not bothering to look in there, those are shower stalls and stuff. Drop and give me 20! Come on. Seriously. Gotta do it the old fashioned way. You are not moving quite enough, sir. Thank you. So Deathclaws don't live in these quarters? Oh, it's a human! Another human over here. Oh! That's interesting. Okay. We've got someone from... I forget that group that I joined. Hello there? A sad older man. Oh, I didn't see you standing there. I hit you with a board to get your attention next. It's okay. We all space out at times. Say, you look rather down. May I ask why? I was born too much premature. When I was one, I was dropped on the porch. When I was two, I had pneumonia. When I was three, I got the chicken pox. When I was four, I fell down the stairs and broke six ribs. When I was five, my uncle was decapitated by a watermelon. What? When I was six, my parents hit me in the head with a shovel. When I was seven, I lost my right index finger to my pet rat. Does this go through all his life? When I was eight, my dog Spike got hit by a tractor. When I was nine, my mother lost her arm to a rabid Brahmin. When I was 10, my sister was torn to bits by a pack of dogs. When I was 11, my grandfather killed himself because I was ugly. When I was 12, my grandmother killed herself because I was ugly. My grandfather, grandmother. When I was 13, my father poked out his eyes with a pitchfork in a drunken stupor. Okay. How long does this go on? When I was 14, my brother lost his hand to a wallaby. When I was 15, my aunt choked to death on a chicken bone. When I was 16, I lost my cousin to a badger. When I was 17, I cut off my left big toe with a hoe. When I was 18, my father lost his right leg to the same tractor that killed my dog. When I was 19... Okay. Yeah, choose this one. Okay, I get the picture. What's currently bothering you? Well, there I was, traveling through the desert, when suddenly my Brahmin falls over dead. About then I realized I was low on water and had a drink in quite a while. Later my bones began to ache, my head started to hurt, my bowels became loose, and I got this rash that just wouldn't go away. It was time to sit down and die. Well, there I was, sitting in the desert, waiting for the world to swallow my miserable existence, when a pack of death claws shows up. Well, I'm thinking to myself, this is it. Now I can die. I can wind up as a pile of death claw shit in the middle of the desert. But no, fate had yet another cruel card to play against me. You see, the death claws didn't kill me. Instead, they gave me water, brought me here, gave me this room, gave me food, cleaned me up, and now they won't let me leave. I know they're fattening me up for some unknown, horrible fate. I keep telling them that I would probably taste better if I was leaner, but it does no good. They just smile, if you can call it that, and pat me on the head and say, "Don't worry, human, things will get better." Ha! We both know what that means. Anyway, to make matters worse, then they started giving me some sort of medication. It was making me gassy, so I stopped taking it, and it's a good thing I did. I think it was some sort of mind control pill, because I started to feel like things weren't actually as bad as I thought. Were they giving him antidepressants? Anyway, that's about it. I'm just waiting for the dinner bell to chime so that they can feast on my bloated body. And away from you. Please tell me that you don't have any children. Nope. When I turned 22, this strange fungus started to grow on my stop! I don't want to know. I don't want to hear his tale again. That was funny as hell, though. Just gonna say... No, that really is not better. Don't come back so quick. Oh, we've got someone here. A tall, slender man, looks like from my tribe. Fortunately, there's nothing here to, like, search through. Is there something that I can help you with, stranger? Yes, I'd like to ask you some questions. What do you want? Who are you? My name is Matt. Does it matter? Not really. Are you a prisoner here? Yes, as a matter of fact, I am. Stumbled upon this place and got myself captured by the Death Claws. They give me freedom of movement within the lower levels of the vault, but I can never go to level 1 where the exit is. Why? Because unlike the rest of the sheep who live here, I recognize them as a threat to humanity. They know that if I get out of here, I will see to it that they are wiped off the face of the earth. Look, they can think for themselves. They can learn. They can read and write. They can read and even write if they dip a claw in ink. They are fast, tough, perceptive, and deadly. If their numbers grow large enough, they will be the greatest threat that the human race could ever face. Think about it. They need to be eliminated. I realize that they are a potential threat, but I trust them.
Argh!
You're a fool to trust them. If you change your mind, come back and get me. Bye. Have you changed your mind? Will you help me get out of here? No. Although I will look into the matter, I can tell you that much. Lenny, seriously. No. We've got this little pass through here. Hi. Religious emblem. Torch. Symbols? They look like little pictures. You see a lean man in long robes. He appears to be in deep thought. Welcome, traveler. I am called Gordon, and I am the shrine keeper. What can I help you with? Oh, his dedicated was turning in their grave. It's a pleasure to meet you, Gordon. I'm Andrea King. Can I ask you some questions? Certainly you may. Dedicated to who? How long have you been here? Death Claws. Who is the shrine dedicated to? This shrine is dedicated to an unnamed hero known only as the Vault Dweller. Ha ha. He, or she, yeah, second one, was the savior of all who lived here several decades ago. We do not know what became of the savior, but he, or she, lives on in our minds and hearts. Very commendable, Gordon. Can I ask you some more questions? How long have you been here? I have lived all my life here in this vault. I have been a shrine keeper for most of those years. You're a very dedicated man. Oh, wait. Then you were here when the Death Claws took over? I'm going to ask him that. No, my friend, I was not. I left a few months ago to visit the statue of the Vault Dweller erected in the central court of the NCR, New California Republic, east of here. Yes, we know of it. When I returned to the vault, I found the Death Claws were already here. Needless to say, I was in shock. However, I am convinced that they are not responsible for what happened to my fellow citizens. If, by chance, you want more information on the matter, you can seek out Goris in the library. Thank you for your help. What can you tell me about the Death Claws? I have lived with the Death Claws for several months now. They seem to be honorable and forthright in their dealings with me and the other humans who live here. I trust them, and in time I think you will as well. Except the other two... Well, at least they claim they cannot leave. I am willing to give them the benefit of the doubt for now. Why do you stay here? My place is here at the shrine. I will not leave it willingly. I vote for dumbass. Your dedication is admirable. Thanks, Gordon. Goodbye. Okay. Another empty place here. Too bad there's no desks or anything to search for. Search through. We need small energy cell, dammit. I don't know why I'm running in these places. There's nothing there. Alright. Yes. You sound scary. Wow. Just gonna save here just in case. What was that sound? Hmm.